Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for this beautiful evening. We come to you with hearts full of gratitude for the gift of life and its every blessings. We thank you, Lord, for blessing our dear children with different talents and for the many opportunities you have provided to showcase them. We also pray that you will bless our esteemed chief guest, management, correspondent, principal, vice principal, parents, teachers, and non-teaching staffs with your abundance and peace. We commit today's program into your mighty hands. Be glorified in all that we do. We ask all this in Jesus' precious name. Amen.
Please be seated. Thank you, Smita ma'am. I now call upon Mrs. Beena Koshi to deliver the welcome address.
Philippe Victor Daillé, a French author and undersea explorer, once said, "The sea is an underwater museum still awaiting its visitors." Welcome to this Under the Sea, a magical experience. Respected chief guest of the day, Mrs. Dr. Sulata Ajit, Honorable Secretary of UCA, Correspondent of Union Christian Matriculation School, Correspondent of Union Christian Public School, Principal of Union Christian Matriculation School, Vice Principal, Union Christian Public School Principal, members of the Board of Management, dear parents, learned teachers, and my dear children, a very good evening to all. I am profoundly honored to have this opportunity today to welcome this gathering to celebrate the Kiddies Day 2023 of our school. At the outset, I take this opportunity to thank God Almighty for the blessings that He has showered on us for making this possible. On this joyous occasion, I'm extremely happy to have with us Mrs. Dr. Sulata Ajit, the founder director of Sangalp Learning Center, Chennai. On behalf of Union Christian Matriculation High Secondary School, I take great pleasure in welcoming you, ma'am. Your eminent presence has indeed made this event a memorable one. The Secretary of UCA and a visionary, Mr. Vinod Simon, needs no introduction. I extend a warm welcome to you to our kindergarten function. Our correspondent, Mrs. Sheba Nainan, is a creative person with full of ideas and enthusiasm. A cordial welcome to you, ma'am, to this program. It's my pleasure to welcome the correspondent of Union Christian Public School, who is present here in spite of her busy schedule. Welcome you, ma'am. Our dear principal, Mrs. Sundarathai Lazarus, who is a pillar of support and strength in all the activities of our school. All these wouldn't have been possible without her guidance. On behalf of KG, I welcome you, ma'am. Mrs. Namita Sara Kurian, vice principal of our school, is a good supporter of all the challenging ventures taken by our school. A warm welcome to you. Most courteous welcome to the Union Christian Public School principal, Mrs. Nisha Anil John, and all the board members of Union Christian Association who are here. The most important key to the success of a child is the positive involvement of parents, not only in academics, but also in extracurricular activities. A special welcome to all the parents. A pleasant welcome to all the teachers present here. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to all the supporting staff of this school. KG Day is an important day on the calendar of Union Christian School. It is the day our KG children make their first step on the stage, either for a dance or for a speech. It is the day for parents to cheer their little ones. It is the day for cameras and videos for clicking the shots of smiling faces. We in UCA believe that, apart from academics, without bringing out the talents, the whole teaching part is incomplete. This KG Day celebration is a great example of that, wherein we ensure that every child participate and perform. The children have made their effort and done preparations along with their untiring teachers. Let us nurture these tender buds carefully and see them bloom into responsible and successful citizens who can build a strong nation. It is not what you do for your children, it is what you taught them to do for themselves that will make them successful human beings. I leave these words with you by Ann Landers, a famous columnist and a media person. Once again, welcome you all to this Under the Sea, a magical experience. Thank you.
Thank you, Beena ma'am. This year was a year that was filled with lots of learning, lots of activities, sports, and much more. May I now request our principal, Mrs. Sundarathai Lazarus, to present the UC Kindergarten Annual Report for the year 2022-23.
Good evening. The annual report of the KG department for the year 2022-23. Children are a gift from the Lord. Psalm 127:3. Every child that enters into the portals of our school is a bundle of talent that we want to nurture and guide with care. This year was no different. School reopened for the KG section on June 22nd for the UKG and June 27th for the LKG. Every year, we begin each day by invoking God's blessing through song and prayer. Our teachers have planned classes meticulously to help every child gain knowledge, develop social skills, and progress in academics. The first big event of the year was the Kindergarten Sports Day held on September 10th. It was a colorful day with children taking part in the march past, drill, and games, all with a sustainability-based theme of Go Green. On September 22nd, we held an open day where parents witnessed a dazzling display of talents by their children. They were also treated to a glimpse of the various activities and academic processes that the children enjoy every day. Singing, coloring, and fancy dress competitions were held in November. We truly appreciate the enthusiasm and involvement of the parents, which made these, especially the fancy dress competition, a vibrant and lively event. In December, our tiny tots took part in a carol singing competition held by the Don Bosco School. In addition to celebrate our country's diversity, various festivals like Diwali, Onam, Christmas, and Pongal were celebrated with great enthusiasm. Fred Rogers says, "Play is often talked about as if it were a relief from serious learning. But for children, play is serious learning. Play is really the work of children." With this in mind, we tweaked the syllabus of the kindergarten classes into 8 categories: spelling, reading, math, painting, gym activities, oral and oral activities, and etiquette and manners. We also constantly observed and evaluated our students. We understood that there were some learning difficulties which are an aftermath of the pandemic and prolonged online education. Digital is no substitute for being in a real-life classroom. To help them through this, we have now embarked on the experimental learning methodology with the aim of engaging students to learn through action, doing, exploring, and discovery. As a result of both these approaches, children are excited to come to school every day. As much as possible, we'd like to continue this process during the summer holidays. We hope that you will expand your children's horizon constantly. The Bible in Proverbs 22:6 says, "Train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it." This is what we as a school are aspiring to do with the help of the wisdom of God. And our desire is that you as parents will be the person that you want your child to be. Because it is not about what you tell your children, but how you show them how to live life. I cannot end this talk without expressing my sincere gratitude to the management for their continuous support, their inputs, and their encouragement. Thank you all.
That was truly heartwarming to see happy faces engrossed in their daily activities. May I now request our correspondent, Mrs. Sheba Nainan, to introduce the chief guest for the day.
A good evening to all of you parents and well-wishers gathered here today. I'm sure all of you enjoyed this video that we just saw, and I'm sure all of you must have been really wondering, I'm sending my child to school, what is happening, and this is what is happening. I hope all of you are glad. I'm sure you're wondering, what are they doing the whole day? And our teachers have really taken a lot of energy, a lot of effort to make sure that every child benefits from all the thinking and advice from our secretary, from our correspondent and others who have asked us to promote teaching in this manner. So I hope you enjoyed the video and also understood what we are trying to do in this school. Now, today we have our very esteemed chief guest, Mrs. Sulata Ajit, and it's indeed my pleasure to introduce her to you. She is the founder director of Sankalp, an institution which functions on the cutting edge of inclusive education through her knowledge and guidance. Having acquired her credentials in special education from Northampton University, UK, she has spearheaded inclusivity and acceptance of children when some time back such children were ignored and branded as unfit to function in this society. So we are very glad to have you here, ma'am. And I would also like to say that our school also, in all children that come here, we want all of them to benefit from education in whichever manner we are giving it to you, accept it, because it's for the benefit of the child. And we want them to understand that this education in the LKG, UKG is very important. These are the first steps. So until parents also oblige and cooperate with us in these first steps, our children will really achieve a lot in their future. Thank you, ma'am. Please come.
Thank you, ma'am. I would request our vice principal, Mrs. Namita Sarah Kurian, to present the chief guest, Dr. Sulata Ajit, with a bouquet. I now request our chief guest, Dr. Sulata Ajit, to address the gathering.
A very good evening to everybody. I'm sure you're waiting to see your children perform, and I don't want to come in between you and your children, but this is indeed an honor, and I thank the principal, vice principal of Union Christian, the management, and my dear teachers. I know all the effort what goes into making children perform, children do their work, because it is a tough work, and it is not easy. So a big applause for the teachers. It was wonderful to see the video and see the pains that the teachers have taken, and the non-teaching staff. I mustn't miss them. They are the other pillars along with the teachers. So wonderful to be present here. And I come from a background of special needs. I don't know how many of you are familiar. They are special children with special needs. They have difficulties, and to see the children perform here, and I think You parents are blessed to have your children coming to this school and, you know, your children going and coming every day and performing and doing so well. But unfortunately, our children, where we come from, where I come from, the children in my school and their parents are not all that fortunate. But they are also blessed with children with special needs, and we do a lot of, you know, the similar kind of work goes on in our school as well. So just to give some small tips, I mean, Beena asked me, I should address you. I don't want to again stand in between you and the cultural event, but just what I believe in, I believe that every child comes with a lot of interests, a lot of talent, a lot of potential, and it is for us as teachers and parents to pick. But I don't want to listen to what they are not good at. We want to listen to what they are good at. And that's very difficult. For many parents, it's very difficult to find out what the child is, you know, good at, and give the opportunity. So opportunities like this, like annual day, sports day, are very, very important, for especially for the young ones. Because this is the first time they come and perform, and without any fear, they do their bit. And from here you can pick out who is good in what and nurture that talent. So there is a psychologist called Howard Gardner, and we do a lot of, you know, we practice Howard Gardner's theory of multiple intelligence. So there are 8 intelligence. So earlier there used to be only the IQ or the intelligence quotient, which is assessed. But now you have 8 intelligence. Along with that is the emotional intelligence, which is very, very important. So in the 8 intelligence, there is something called body intelligence, bodily kinesthetic intelligence, visual intelligence. There is logical, mathematical, verbal, linguistic. Verbal, linguistic, and logical, mathematical are intelligence which are generally assessed in schools. But beyond that, there are a lot of you know, skills which children are good at. So Howard Gardner's saying, he says, it is not how smart you are, but how you are smart. There's a difference in that. It is how smart you are. Are you a body smart? Are you visual smart? Are you musical smart? Are you you know, visual smart? What's how smart you are. So that is the important part, and that is, I think, what parents have to look at, not at only the academic part, or, you know, my child. And there's no more now, everybody doesn't look at aim at becoming a doctor or an engineer. There are so many different areas every child can get into. So, and you as young parents, young mothers, I think looking at how your child is, in what area he is good at, and picking on that, and, you know, finding that out and nurturing that, is the most important goal, I think, as young mothers, because that's very, very difficult, because all the time, and compare them with their own strengths, not to compare them with the other's strength, to compare them on their own linear strengths. So today, if he is good in one thing, tomorrow, how good will he be in the other area? The other thing, a small bit which I would like to share, is don't live your dreams out of your child, because your child has another set of dreams. So, you know, many parents live their dreams out of their child. If I couldn't get it, my child should get double. So that is another thing which we as psychologists, we as teachers, advise our parents. That child has a lot of interest, lot of potential. He has to be himself. He cannot be you or your husband or your other sibling, other child. So he has a set. He's a child by himself or herself. So let him live his own life. And I would like to end today's, you know, a little bit of my knowledge or whatever I have shared with you. The teacher is indeed wise who does not bid you to enter the house of his wisdom, but rather leads you to the threshold of his own mind. This is Khalil Gibran in the Prophet. So don't live your life, or even the teachers, I feel they shouldn't live their lives. I mean, you know, compare them, one child with another. So this is just a small, you know, my bit of two words which I would like to share. And thank you again for calling me, inviting me here. And I'm looking forward to this wonderful event. And I can see all the decorations and beautiful, lovely. So thanks a lot.
Thank you, ma'am, for those enlightening and inspiring words. It was really thought-provoking. I request our General Secretary, Mr. Vinod Simon, to present our chief guest with a memento as a token of our love and appreciation. We have Alice of UKG to introduce the cultural events for us.
Good evening. One of the most amazing wonders of God's creations is the vast world of oceans. We, the students of KG, are going to open your eyes to the fantasy world of oceans, filled with shells, corals, jellyfish, starfish, sharks, octopus, seahorses, dolphins, I wonder. Oh, Mr. Beautiful Mermaid, God's creations are marvelous. Sit back and relax.
Thank you.
let's give it up for the future singers of the UC. Thank you, children. We have a dance by the Tiny Tots of the LKG. I call Sanishri to introduce the dance.
You must see that we have no brain, blood, bones, lungs or eyes. They might be newcomers to this planet, and he might be extremely fragile, but we are always the only one who can decide to change. Just wait and watch all my friends dance to the tune. Enjoy.
That was really beautiful, children. Thank you so much. After that vibrant jellyfish dance, we have the turtles here. May I call Enoch to introduce the turtle dance?
Hi, friends. My name is Enoch. We are little turtles who live in shells and swim in puddles. We are slow movers, are not watchers how fast we move.
I like to move and move it. We like to move it. I like to move and move it. She like to move and move it. He like to jumping off the floor, dancing till your feet are sore. Party hard, it's like it's Mardi Gras, cause that's what life is for. And we don't party hardly, we just party hard. And not because we born, we party cause we born apart. That's why I keep on just, that's why I keep on just, that's why I keep on doing, doing what I'm doing, y'all. I like the moving, moving, I like the moving, moving, I like the moving, moving, we like the moving. I like the moving, moving, she like the moving, moving, he like the moving, moving, we like the moving. I like the body, body, he like the body, body, they like the body, body, we like the body. She like to shake it, shake it, she like to shake it, shake it, he like to shake it, yeah. Somebody say yeah,
yeah.
Say yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah.
Back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up, back it up. Back it up, 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 back it up. Give me room, give me room, give me room, cause we like to party, party, we like to party, party, we like to party, party, we like to party. We like to move and move it, he like to move and move it, they like to move and move it, move it, move it, move it, move it, move it.
That was energetic. Thank you, little turtles. With that, we come to the end of the LKG programs. We move on to the UKG entertainment. It's the UKG program. We have the pretty mermaids on the stage. May I request Tiara to introduce the mermaid dance?
We have not yet reached the end of a fantasy trip. If you have never seen beautiful mermaids before, well, wait and watch. Here they are, the most beautiful creatures you had ever seen. Well, now entertain you with the dance.
Thank you, children, for that very cute performance.
we move on to the shark dance. May I request Shad to introduce the shark dance for us.
Do you know the sharks have lived on Earth since before dinosaurs? They are a type of fish who live in the ocean. Do you know what secret? Since the dinosaurs don't live in the ocean, it's a good thing that sharks don't get cavities. Some sharks are very scary and some are very gentle. Can we watch the gentle shark dancing to a merry tune?
That was energetic. Thank you, children. With that, we come to the end of the colorful entertainment show presented by our kindergarten kids. A special mention about the choreographers of this program. It's none other than our very own KG teachers. Shall we give it up for them? And not only that, all the colorful props and cutouts that you look around, that you can see around you, and all the props that you saw on the stage was all handmade by our very own KG teachers. Let's give them a wide round of applause. With that, we come to the end of a delightful evening. May I now call upon Mrs. Sheena Clement to propose the vote of thanks.
Honorable Chief Guest for the evening, respected members of the Board of Management of Union Christian Association, beloved Principal, Vice Principal, Principal of Union Christian Public School, my dear parents, colleagues and children. I thank the Almighty for His blessings showered upon us today to conduct this program beautifully. On behalf of the Union Christian family, I take this opportunity to thank our esteemed Chief Guest, Mrs. Sulata Ajit, for accepting our invitation and taking time off a busy schedule to grace this occasion. We are highly grateful to our correspondent, Mrs. Sheba Nainan, Secretary, Mrs. Vinod Simon, correspondent and the principal of Union Christian Public School and all the board members who are present here today in spite of the busy schedule. I extend my sincere thanks to our respected principal and our vice principal for their guidance and support for this event. Thank you, dear teachers, for being a part of the celebration and all the help with a grateful heart. I recollect the valuable services provided by all our non-teaching staff. I also extend my sincere thanks to all the parents for their excellent cooperation. I thank the blooming buds of this institution for the cute performances. I will be failing in my duty if I don't thank the KG teachers who have worked tirelessly to make this happen. We sincerely hope that you must have enjoyed the energy, enthusiasm and efforts put in by our KG students. We are indeed grateful for your time and your presence here. Thank you once again and God bless you all.
Thank you, Sheena ma'am. Shall we all stand for the national anthem?
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध